वेलकम बैक एस्पिरेंट्स ऑन मैकटेक 40 एंड टुडे वी विल सॉल्व टू क्वेश्चंस ऑफ गेट 2019 दैट आर वेरी कंसेप्चुअल क्वेश्चन दैट विल टेस्ट योर हाउ मच यू क्लियर विथ योर कंसेप्ट. वन क्वेश्चन इज बेस्ड ऑन रेडिएशन एंड सेकेंड इज बेस्ड ऑन ड्रैग फोर्स. ओके सो एट द एंड ऑफ वीडियो यू हैव टू टेल मी what is the how the question was and how the solution was. Okay, because both the question I found very interesting. So let's start with first question on the based on the drag forces. So the question is, the aerodynamic drag on the sports car depends upon its shape. The car has a drag coefficient 0.1 with windows and roofs. That means when windows and roofs are closed of the sports car, so the drag coefficient that is acting on the body, it is 0.1, and with the windows and roofs open, the drag coefficient is 0.8. so that means when we open the windows and roof, so the drag coefficient become 0.8 cd. The car travels 44 km per hour. This is the velocity given when windows and roofs closed. Okay, for the same amount of power needed to overcome the aerodynamic drag, okay, the speed of car, that means the same amount of power is needed to overcome the aerodynamic drag. This is the heart of this question. The speed of the car with the windows and roof open, so what is the speed at that time, and round off we have to two decimal place. That means there is a sports car like this. Okay, just take for our simplicity purpose we have taken this, and when the shape, where this is when the windows and roof is closed, and when roof is open, so the shape will be like this. Okay, so now what happens here, when this flow, then this roof is closed, then the streamlines will flow like this. Okay, so there is some drag coefficient, and as we increase the speed, the drag will be more. Okay, so when our car shape is like this, roofs open, so our streamlines will be like this. It may be get turbulent over here, okay, in this region. So to compensate this drag, we have to reduce the speed. Okay, as we reduce the speed, this turbulence will get reduced and the flow will become streamlined. Okay, okay, I hope you're clear that as we increase the velocity, the drag will increase. Okay, but when the windows is closed, so the drag coefficient will be 0.1, but when the car is open and as we move with the same speed, then drag force will be more, so your car will be retarded as. Okay, so to compensate that retardation effect and to reduce this drag effect, so that we have to reduce the speed of the car, but our engine produce the same power needed to overcome here. So when car is in close condition, so the same power we have, because in open condition, okay, this is the, so the power will required will be same. Okay, because here drag coefficient is more. So how the force is given is, force, okay, into velocity, unit velocity, that will give you power. Okay, force into velocity, that will give you a power, as you know. And what is the force as per the, and now one thing before clear me, you have heard that the air or any fluid is exerting a drag force on the fluid. Okay, so the same amount of to move this in against the direction, we have to compensate that drag force. Okay, so here it will return that to compensate, to overcome that drag, that means we have to not cross the limit of the drag force, we have to just on the reach of the drag force. So the force will be same as the force exerted by the fluid on the car, and the force that we have to compensate is by engine power, that is same as the drag force. Okay, So force will be what? As per the second law of Newton, second law of motion, rate of change of momentum, okay, mass into mass flow rate into velocity, okay, m dot v, rate of change of momentum. And what is the mass flow? Rho a v square mass flow, and here velocity also, sorry, rho a v mass flow is rho a v, as you studied in fluid mechanics, that is mass flow is given by rho a v per unit area, okay, rho a v. So your momentum will become rho a v square. So rate of force is rate of change of momentum rho a v square, okay. Now again velocity component we have to multiply, so our effective force power will be rho a v cube, and this flow is real because the drag coefficient is given, so we have to multiply with coefficient of drag also, cd. So let me write here the power to compensate the drag force in closed position is equal to power to compensate the drag force in open position, okay, this is given. So what is the drag coefficient? Power is drag coefficient in closed condition into rho a v cube, okay, we have seen in our previous slide, is same as drag coefficient in open position into rho a v cube in open position. So now density and area, here the area will be not cross section, area will be swept frontal area, the area which will in the direction of the flow of air, that is known as swept frontal area, it will remain same. So now we have drag coefficient into v cube in closed position, same as drag coefficient into v cube in open position. So in closed position drag coefficient is 0.1 and velocity is 44 km per hour whole cube. Drag coefficient is 0.8 when the car is open. So to compensate that drag at the same power, we have some required velocity in open position. So just solve this, you will get sorry 0.8, this is a will, this will become 8, okay. So just take cube root on the both side. So velocity in open condition will be 44 divided by cube root of 8 will be 2, so it is 22. So to compensate the drag we have to reduce our speed to 22 km per hour. So your answer will be round off to 2 decimal place, that means, but here nothing in decimal, we have in integer, so 22 is the answer. Hope you guys understand. This is a very good concept, that is to overcome, just overcome the drag force, okay. So to that, what is the to overcome? The power required is same as the drag force, okay, and we have to multiply with velocity. Second, this is very good question of radiation asked till the date of today, okay. The three parallel plates LM, NR and PQ, here one plate LM, NR, PQ is given in the figure 1, 2, 3. The view factor FIJ is defined as the fraction of radiation leaving the plate I and intercepted by J. That means due to radiation some heat is leaving from this surface and intercepted by this plane, okay, and there is some losses in between radiation, space losses, okay. So how much amount of fraction of energy that will reach on the other surface, that is given by Fij, or we can say that shape factor or view factor, okay. So for shape factor LM, that means amount of energy leaving the surface L and reaching to the surface M, that means here the whole surface, this 3 meter width, is 0.8, FLM is 0.8, and NR, that means amount of energy radiating from surface N, and due to space resistance, the energy intercepted on the R plane, that is 0.4, 40%, or you can say that FNR, that is 0.8. Now we have to find the value for PQ. Okay, what is the how much amount of energy radiated by PQ, and what is the view factor for this? Okay, now in the our question that in our theoretical class in your college or any other place, you have seen that is the here there is two plate. Okay, view factor is, so whatever amount of energy is leaving the surface, it's some portion is intercepted, okay, and some portion is reflected back, and this process continues till the equilibrium is achieved. So in this case we have taken one assumption while the calculation, that is cross section area, okay, that is same. For example, if this plate have a 1 meter square cross section area, so this plate will have also same 1 meter square area, okay. But here what, one plate is some with some dimension like this 1 meter, and this is quite bigger, okay. So energy will be leave not in radiation in a linear direction, it will be go in transverse direction also to cover this whole area, okay, which area is exposed to this surface, okay, it will distribute in all these three portions, okay. So here same thing, the LM energy is transferred and it is wholly distributed on this area and this area also, and from N to M the energy will be directed towards this, and here there is a dotted portion given in the question, it represents that the fraction of area that is dotted in between this dotted line is same. This is 1 meter, again this is 1 meter and 1 meter, 1 meter, okay. So suppose it is 1 meter square area, so this area will be 1 meter square, and suppose it is the way in perpendicular direction, width will change, that is 3 meters square, okay, because this is 3 meter and the width in perpendicular to plane is 1 meter, so this 111, that is 3 meter length, so this is 3 meter cube area. So area is changing, here area will remain same, again here area is changing. So as per the algebraicity of the view factor, here we have to use two concepts. One is algebraicity and reciprocal theorem, okay. Algebraicity and reciprocal. So what is this? That is the total amount of energy is reflected in radiated in this three portion as I have shown in the question, okay, like this. Yes, this. So this is the, suppose this is surface one, L surface, take as one first surface, this as a second surface, this intermediate as third, and this is as a fourth, okay. So the amount of energy that is radiated from surface one, it is a summation, the fraction view factor is summation of one and fraction added in two and fraction added in three, okay. So here the total amount of energy, that is one to this surface L to M, okay, this is LM, is the F122, F123 and F124, okay, in three portion it is acting, and but here cross section area will remain same, okay. Here let me write here F12, F14 and F13, that means fraction of energy leaving the surface from one and reaching the surface two, okay, like this. But here due to symmetricity, the energy that is reached on the surface 2 is same, that is the fraction of energy will reach from surface 1 to 4. So we can write as 2 times F12 plus F13, and total fraction of energy, that is 0.8, it is given. Now here, when this both are parallel to each other, not at inclined at some angle, so it is value is given, the FNR, that means when this plate, this surface is 1 and this surface is 2, so when they are parallel to each other, okay, and no angular inclination, so the friction, that view factor is 0.4. okay, so here in this case 1 and 3, this surface is 1 and 3, these are parallel and no any angular inclination, so this will be same. Okay, so it is 0.4, 2 times F12 plus 0.4. so when you solve this, you will get the fraction of energy radiating from surface 1 and reaching the surface 2, that is 0.2. that means at angular inclination like this, 0.2% of energy is intercepted by another plane. Now here, this P plate, consider this 1 meter section area as a 1, this parallel section as 2, and this at angular inclination area 3. So now here some energy will be intercepted by here to this portion 2, and some energy at 3. So now we have the value of view factor when these both plates are parallel, that is 0.4. so 0.4, and due to additive principle, at angular inclination we have 0.2. Due to when this surface are parallel, sorry, 0.4, and at angular inclination 0.2. so total is 0.6 view factor. So this is the answer, and we have to write up to one decimal place, so our answer is 0.6. so this is the answer. Hope you guys understand the concept behind this, and tell me in the comment section how was this question and how was the solution. Okay, so tomorrow we will meet with Indian Forest Service or any other exam like ESC or CA, Civil Service. We will solve mains question, okay, as per our schedule. Till then, keep studying, stay focused.